गुड मॉर्निंग, माई सेल्फ मनोज कुमार बुंदेला, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर सुरेश ज्ञान विहार यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। सो वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द प्रोडक्शन टेक्नोलॉजी ऑफ वेजिटेबल एंड स्पाइसेस। सो इन दिस टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द प्रोडक्शन टेक्नोलॉजी ऑफ ब्रोकली। सो इंट्रोडक्शन, सो ब्रोकली, द साइंटिफिक नेम ऑफ ब्रोकली इज ब्रेसिका ओलेरेसिया वेराइटी इटैलिका। Family is Brassicaceae or Cruciferae. The old name is Cruciferae, now it is the name of Brassicaceae. The origin of broccoli is Mediterranean region. Normally we can say it is originated from Italy. The chromosome number 2N is equal to 2X is equal to 18. It is a progenitor of Brassica oleracea variety Psilostis. So all coal crops, that is called as coal wart, we can say. So all coal crops like cabbage, cauliflower, broccoli, knoll coal, kale, sprouting broccoli, so these all are the originated from the single progenitor, that is Brassica oleracea variety Psilostis. So this is, you can see the broccoli. So the word broccoli is came from brocco. Brocco is an Italian word. The meaning of that is suit. So the economic part is a suit, that is the economic part of broccoli. The sprouting broccoli is sometime briefly called as broccoli. So we can say it is sprouting broccoli, we can say, or we can say it is a broccoli. This is not so much popular vegetable in our country. It is mostly cultivated in hilly regions of Himachal Pradesh, Jammu Kashmir, Uttar Pradesh and Nilgiri Hills. It is mainly cultivated in hilly areas of India. It is not grown in plain. Now it is grown in plains also. Even in Rajasthan, Jaipur also we are growing. Morphologically, sprouting broccoli is resembles cauliflower. Like it is look like the cauliflower only. Sprouting broccoli, it is look like the cauliflower only. The plant form a kind of head consisting of green buds and thick fleshy stalk. Stalks generally longer than the cauliflower. The cauliflower, the stalk length is small, very small length is their stalk. But in case of broccoli, the length of stalk is big. So the stalk is longer than the cauliflower. The edible part is terminal head, but sometimes the sprouts also. Means the terminal head is the edible part, but sprouts also we can use with a terminal. So terminal head is developed by the axillary leaves, means the axil of the leaves, the terminal heads will develop, and that terminal head is the edible portion of the sprouting broccoli. Next is composition of broccoli per 100 gram of edible part. So it contains water 89.9%, carbohydrates 5.5%, protein 3.3%, fat 0.2%, energy it will provide 37 calorie energy it will provide, vitamin A 9000 international unit, vitamin B 33 international unit, vitamin E 137 international unit, calcium 1.29%, phosphorus 0.79%, potassium 3.5%, sulfur 1.26%, iron 205 ppm parts per million, iodine 1.965 ppm and copper 24 ppm. So it contains the almost all vitamin and minerals. Even it contains the fat, energy, vitamins and minerals. Uses: both head and fleshy stems are eaten as a salad or cooked as a single or a mixed vegetable with potato. So either we can use as, we can consume it as a cooked, or we can consume, we can use as a raw, means as a salad also we can use. Normally we can mix it by the potato and we can prepare the mixed veg. It has 130 times more vitamin A than the cauliflower and 22 times more than the cabbage. So it has the more vitamin A content as compared to the cabbage and cauliflower. It has the anti-carcinogenic property, means it works against the cancer. It is a rich source of sulforaphane, a compound associated with the reducing the risk of cancer. So sulforaphane kya aata hai? It is a chemical that is mainly used to reduce the risk of cancer. So it is work as a anti-carcinogenic. It is also benefit in heart disease. So it will reduce the heart blood pressure. It is used to prepare the salad, soup, curry, pie. Boiling more than 10 times reduce its nutritional quality. So normally we will not go for so much of boiling. If we go for boiling of nolkol, I mean if we go for boiling of broccoli, so the nutritional content will be reduced. Next is cultivars. There are green, white, purple colored cultivars, but only green type are generally grown. So there are different colored cultivars are available in market, but only majorly it is grown in green type only. Like in case of cauliflower also different color cauliflowers are available. In case of cabbage also different color cabbage are available, but the major growing area in case of green only. That same in case of broccoli also different color broccoli are available, but the major area of in green broccoli only. The early maturity varieties, they will mature in 60 to 70 days only. They will take only 60 to 70 days. The name of the varieties are Green Bud, Parton Early, Waltham 29, Green Mountain, Atlantic, Palam Smriti, Pusa KTS 1. So these some varieties they are developed in South, means other country of India, not grown in India. But the major some varieties they are grown in India and they are developed in India itself, like Palam Smriti, Pusa KTS 1. So Pusa KTS means the variety which are released from Pusa, they are released from IARI New Delhi. The name is start with Pusa means they are released from IARI New Delhi and Palam Smriti. So these are the some varieties which are comes under the early maturity group. They will take 60 to 70 days. Next is mid maturity group. So mid maturity means they will mature in 90 to 110 days. They will take 90 to 110 days for maturity. So the example is green sprouting medium. Green sprouting medium is a name of variety. It will mature in 90 to 110 days. Late maturity varieties. The late maturity varieties are, they will mature in 110 to 120 days. 110 to 120 days. Green sprouting late. So green sprouting medium means medium maturity. Green sprouting late means they are late maturing variety. The F1 hybrid that is developed by the private sectors like Southern Comet, Premium Crop, Clippers, Laser, Tiff, Emerged Corona, Green Surf, Late Corona and Emerged Corona. So these are also the varieties which are developed in case of broccoli, F1 hybrids. Climate. It is a sensitive to temperature and warm weather. It causes the small thin leaves and loose heads. Means it is a more sensitive. If the temperature is more, then the head will not develop. The sprouts will not develop if the temperature is more. So it is a sensitive to temperature. If temperature is more, then the head will not develop. The optimum temperature for growth is 20 to 30 degrees centigrade for early and 5 to 10 degrees centigrade for late. If you are growing the early crop, then 20 to 30 degrees centigrade temperature and 5 to 10 degrees centigrade for the late crop. The optimum temperature for heading is 15 to 20 degrees centigrade. Optimum temperature for heading is 15 to 20 degrees centigrade temperature. Some varieties are tolerant to frost, but the annual types are sensitive. So some varieties they are tolerant to frost and some varieties are sensitive to the frost. Is soil. So it is grown in sandy to sandy loamy soil. Is good. The pH of the soil is 6 to 6.8. Is mainly good for growing of broccoli. The water stagnation is a problem, so heavy soil should be avoided. So in soil means water stagnation is the problem in case of sandy loamy soil. So normally it is not grown in heavy soils. Soil should be fertile with good moisture content. So whatever soil we have to select, it is fertile soil we have to select and it have the good moisture content. Land preparation. The land should be thoroughly prepared by the plowing 3 to 4 times and make it friable. So 2 to 3 times we will go for plowing and make the soil is friable. It should be leveled properly before making the small beds for planting the crop. Normally we have to go for properly leveling. After that we will prepare the bed. The size of the bed is 3 into 3 or 4 into 4 meter. So normally when we prepare the bed, the size of the bed is 3 meter into 3 meter or 4 meter into 4 meter. The land is prepared about 1 month before of the sowing. And we apply the 15 to 20 tons of well-rotten FIM should be incorporated in the soil. So we will go for land preparation, means we will go for plowing 1 month before the sowing, so that after that we will expose the soil to the sunlight. After that we will add the FIM, farmyard manure. So we will apply the well-rotten FIM into the soil. It is 15 to 20 ton FIM we have to apply. Sowing. The sowing time is September to mid-November in North India. North India, the time of sowing is September to mid-November. Both direct sowing and transplanting methods are used. So normally we can first we prepare the nursery bed, then we will go for transplanting into the main field. Direct sowing is not so much beneficial, but if we go for transplanting, means it is best. So for transplanting, first we prepare the nursery bed. So nursery bed means the height of the bed is 15 to 20 centimeter and the diameter of the bed is 1 meter diameter we will take, and length is according to the requirement of seedlings. So after that we will make the lines, we will go for line sowing and we will sow the seeds. The seeds will start germinate in 5 to 6 days. After 5 to 6 days the seeds will start germinate. Then there is a major problem in the nursery is damping off. So to control the damping off, we will apply the Kapton or Thyron 3 gram per kg per liter of water. Then we will spread it. Both direct, in direct sowing 2 to 2.5 kg seeds per acre is required. But in transplanting the seed rate is less, 500 to 600 gram seeds are only sufficient. If we go for transplanting, then it required only 5 to 600 gram seeds. Transplanting 3 to 4 week old seedlings are transplanted to the main field. Means in nursery it will take 3 to 4 weeks, and the spacing is 16 to 45. When we go for transplanting we will maintain the spacing 16 to 45 centimeter. In direct sowing method, thinning is essential after 15 to 20 days of sowing. In direct sowing means directly we will sow the seeds, so there is a, in one place the number of plants will be more. So if the number of plants will be more in one place, then we will go for thinning. If in thinning, then there is a hand will not develop properly. This is how we plant. We will take the seedlings from the nursery, then we separate the one seedlings and we transplant the one seedling at one place. So this is how we can go for transplanting of broccoli seedlings. Fertilizer application: 60 to 80 kg of nitrogen, 60 to 80 kg of phosphorus and 40 to 60 kg of potassium are recommended for 1 hectare. So for 1 hectare we will apply the 60 to 80 nitrogen and phosphorus and 40 to 60 potassium. So normally nitrogen we apply in 2 split dose. We will not apply the nitrogen in full dose of nitrogen at one time, because in nitrogen the major problem is leaching loss. The nitrogen will be, if we apply the nitrogen, it will go inside the soil with the water, means it will mix into the water, it will go inside the water and it will not available to the plant roots. And second is denitrification losses are there, means whatever nitrogen you apply it will denitrate and it will go to the atmosphere. So to control that we have to apply the nitrogen in split dose. So normally 2 or 3 split dose we have to apply the nitrogen. So half dose of nitrogen and full dose of P and K we apply as a basal dose. And the rest half dose of nitrogen is top dose. Rest half dose of nitrogen we apply in 2 split dose. Means half dose of nitrogen we apply during the land preparation and remaining half dose we apply in 2 split dose. 30 to 35 days after transplanting and second after head formation. When the head formation will be start, that time we apply the nitrogen and 1 dose we apply 30 to 35 days after transplanting. Sometime boron and molybdenum is also recommended. Irrigation. Frequent irrigation at 10 to 15 days interval are given depending upon the weather condition. So normally if the weather is the summer, means the temperature is more, then we apply the frequently we have to irrigate the crop. If the temperature is less, देन अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट वी हैव टू अप्लाई द वाटर। इंटरकल्चर ऑपरेशन, इट इज अ सैलो रूटेड क्रॉप। नॉर्मली वी कैन नो दैट इट इज अ सैलो रूटेड क्रॉप, सो होइंग इज अर्ली स्टेज इज नीडेड एंड शुड बी डन 5 to 6 cm नियर टू द प्लांट। मीन्स नॉर्मली द होइंग टाइम इज, नॉर्मली इट इज अ सैलो रूटेड क्रॉप, सो वैन वी गो फॉर रिमूव द वीड, वैन वी गो फॉर होइंग, द रूट्स विल बी अफेक्टेड बाई द दैट होइंग टाइम। सो वैन एवर वी गो फॉर होइंग, वी हैव टू मेंटेन द 5 to 6 cm अवे फ्रॉम द प्लांट वी हैव टू गो फॉर होइंग। एंड इफ द वीड्स आर नियर टू द प्लांट, दैट स्लोली वी हैव टू रिमूव द वीड्स सो दैट द प्लांट रूट्स विल बी नॉट अफेक्टेड। इफ द प्लांट रूट्स आर अफेक्टेड, देन वी विल गो फॉर अर्थिंग अप। मीन्स वी विल गो फॉर अर्थिंग अप, लाइट अर्थिंग अप वी विल डू सो दैट द सॉइल विल नॉट एक्सपोज टू द सनलाइट। ए लाइट अर्थिंग अप एट ए फाइनल लोइंग इज बेनिफिशियल। द प्री प्लांटिंग स्प्रे, सो वी कैन यूज द वीडिसाइड्स ऑल्सो, हर्बिसाइड्स वी कैन यूज like pre-planting spray of basaline 2 kg per hectare followed by 2 hoeing to control the weed effectively. So 2 hand hoeing we can use and one is basaline we can use. Harvesting, the central head is harvested before the bud open and the bud clusters are compact. So when the head is compacting, means it will completely compact and the buds will not start opening, that time the buds will just this before the buds will start opening, that we have to harvest the heads. The head may be 15 to 25 centimeter in diameter and 250 to 600 gram in weight. So when we harvest the head, the diameter of the head is 15 to 25 centimeter and weight is 250 to 600 gram. The head are cut off with about 15 centimeter, means 15 centimeter above we have to cut the head on the stem attached, and after cutting the part of foliage is removed from the harvested shoots. So means whatever the shoots head we have to harvest, with that if the any parts of leaves are there, that we have to remove. Like this is the broccoli head we have to harvest. Just you have to remember that the diameter of the head whatever we harvested is 15 to 25 centimeter and the weight is 250 to 600 gram. Total yield, in early type of variety the yield is 50 to 60 quintal per hectare. In late type of varieties the yield is 100 to 150 quintal per hectare. In average yield is 75 to 100 quintal per hectare. So in early and late, the late varieties the yield is more and the early varieties the yield is less, means it is the less, just half the yield. Late means it will give the just double the yield by the early varieties. The average yield is 75 to 100 quintal per hectare. This is, you can see the harvested broccoli. Post harvest handling. So after harvest, the heads are kept in dark place for some time, otherwise they become yellowish. So just after harvesting, we will keep the head in dark place so that the yellowing will not occur. Yellowing can be checked by sorting in oxygen-free chambers for application of benzoic acid 10 ppm for 2,4,5-T2,4,5-trichloroacetic acid at the rate of 2 to 4 ppm 3 to 4 days before harvesting. So this is yellowing is the major problem after harvesting. So to control that, we can spray the benzoic acid 2,4,5-T, or we can prepare the chamber that is free from the oxygen. Storage, the heads can be stored at 32 degree Fahrenheit temperature and 80 to 85% RH for 8 to 10 days. Means we can store the head 8 to 10 days at 80 to 85% relative humidity. So this is, we can store the heads of the broccoli. Disease. So there is a major disease is damping off. So as I already told you, damping off is mainly occurs in the nursery stage. When we prepare the nursery, that time damping off the major problem. It is mainly caused by the Pythium and Rhizoctonia. The symptoms are generated, the seed are killed or the seedlings topple down due to the collar rot. The collar rot will be start from the stem and the seedlings will be fall down. To control this, we can go for seed treatment with Capton and Thyrone 3 gram per kg of the seed, or we can spray the 0.2% of diethane M45, or we can go for soil solarization. Because the fungus are present inside the soil, if we go for soil solarization, so we can control the damping off. नेक्स्ट इज डाउनी मिल्ड्यू. डाउनी मिल्ड्यू इट इज मेनली कॉज बाय द पद्मस्पोरा पैरासिटिका. सो डाउनी ग्रोथ विल बी अपियर्स ऑन द लोअर सर्फेस ऑफ द लीव्स और द लीव्स विल बी लुक लाइक द पर्पलिश ईयर और येलोविंग ऑफ द स्पॉट. येलोविंग स्पॉट्स विल बी अपियर्स ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ द लीव्स. दीज आर द सिम्टम्स ऑफ डाउनी मिल्ड्यू. मीन्स डाउनी ग्रोथ विल बी अपियर्स ऑन द लोअर सर्फेस ऑफ द लीव्स एंड पर्पलिश और येलोविश स्पॉट्स विल बी अपियर्स ऑन द लीव्स. So, no, to control the downy mildew, we can go for seed treatment in hot water of 50 degrees centigrade for 30 minutes. We can go for seed treatment, or we can use the 0.3% diethan M45 or Redomil. We can use 72. Yellowing. It is mainly caused by Fusarium oxysporum. In yellowing means yellowing of the leaves starting from the lower leaves and leading to the upper leaves. Means the yellowing of the leaves will start from the lower leaves and it will go to the upper leaves. So to control the yellowing, we can go for seed treatment and 0.2% carbendazim or benlet we can use to control the yellowing. Next is club rot. So club rot is mainly caused by the plasmodifora. So the swelling of the root causes the club-shaped rot, rootless. Means the roots means the it is have the shallow root system. So in shallow root system, the roots will be club at one place and they will make like a club like structures they will make. So that it will not absorb the so much, means so much amount of minerals and water it will not absorb. Drenching of the seed bed with 1% formaldehyde or liming to correct the pH of the soil. Means normally in acidic soil, the club rot is the major problem. So we will apply the lime. So if we apply the lime, so we can correct the acidic soil and we can control the club rot. Black leg, foma lingam. Black leg is caused by the foma lingam. Seedlings are topple overdue due to the distortion of vascular bundles and root system. We can go for seed treatment, hot water treatment we can go, or spray the 0.2% diethan M45. You can see the symptoms like black leg. Like this black leg will develop on the stem of the black rot. So black rot is caused by Xanthomonas compressatis. The V-shaped lesion with brown vein on the leaf. So it will develop, the V-shaped lesion will be developed in black leg on the brown vein of the leaves. The leaves when we start browning. So you can see the symptoms of botrytis. The hot water seed treatment we can go for hot water seed treatment. Seedlings are treated with 0.01% of streptocycline. Spray the 0.01% of streptocycline to control the black rot. Next is soft rot. Soft rot is caused by Erythrina crotovora. So it is water-soaked patches on the head which later turns into the dark brown. In soft rot, the water-soaked patches are developed on the head and later they will turn into the brown color as black rot. So we can go for hot water treatment to control the soft rot. Seedling treatment with 0.01% streptocycline we can go to control this. So downy mildew, the downy growth will be appears on the lower surface of the leaves, and on the upper surface of the leaf the yellow patches will be developed, yellow thing like structures will be developed. So these are the symptoms of downy mildew. In powdery mildew, the powdery growth will be appears on the upper surface of the leaves. Black leg, these are the symptoms of yellowing of the leaves. These are club rot, the roots will be start clubbing. So these are the symptoms of club rot. Gray mold, the symptoms of gray mold, bacterial soft rot on broccoli. So these are the due to the attack of bacteria. Insect and pest. So insect, the major insect is cabbage butterfly. So cabbage butterfly is bluish green caterpillars feed on the leaves starting from the margin of the leaves. Cabbage butterfly, the large damaging stage is caterpillars, and the caterpillars they will feed the margin of the leaves. They will start from the margin and enter into the center. To control this, we can grow the paired mustard row, after every 25 row of the crop. So mustard, if we can grow the mustard, if we grow the mustard, then they will first they will attack to the mustard, and then they will attack to the main crop. So mustard is the main host. Spray the 0.03% of cypermethrin we can spray to control the cabbage butterfly. So it is cabbage butterfly means normally we have to control the insect. So insect we can go to use the insecticides. Cutworm, Agrotis ipsela. So caterpillars, they will cut down the young seedlings just above the ground level. Just above the ground level, the young seedlings are there. They will cut down it, cutworm. So for that, to control this, what we have to do? We will go for clean cultivation, destruction of big soil clouds. If the big soil clouds are there, that we have to break down that. Soil application of eldarine, 20 kg per hectare to control the cutworms. Cabbage aphid. So cabbage aphid is the damaging stages, nymph and adult, they will suck the sap from the leaves and cause the sooty mold. Means they will suck the sap from the leaves and it will cause the, they will cause the sooty mold symptoms. They spray the 0.03% of dimethoate or 0.05% of methyl dimethone. Diamondback moth, Plutella exophis. 1 centimeter long greenish caterpillars feed on the lower side of the leaves. Diamondback, thus damaging stage is caterpillar, and they will feed the lower side of the leaves and producing the white faces and make the holes on the leaves. So we can control measure. So control measure we can use grow the paled mustard row, we can grow, or we can use the cypermethrin. Cabbage flea beetle. So cabbage flea beetle, it is the grub feed on the tender. The damaging stage is grub, and the grub will feed the tender roots and adult in bluish green. 1.5 to 2 centimeter long and make the small round holes on the leaves. They will make the small round hole on the leaves. To control this, we can spray the 0.2% of carbaryl. So these are the symptoms. These are the caterpillar in cabbage white butterfly. The caterpillar is the damaging stage. These are the caterpillars. They will eat the leaves from the, they will start from the end of the point and they will eat. This is the cabbage butterfly. So it will spray the viral disease. So armyworas of the leaves. Armyvora, this is the armyvora, the moth, it will damage its head, is caterpillar. This is the aphids on broccoli leaf, so they will transfer the aphid on the broccoli stalk, so they will transfer the viral disease and damage the main crop. Next is physiological disorders. The physiological disorders means there's a different disorders and their cause and control. So first one is brown or red rot. Browning or red rot or brown rot. The water soaked lesions will appear on the leaf and head, which later turns into the rusty brown. So in browning, red rot or brown rot, what will happen? The water soaked lesion will appear on the leaf and head, and after that it will be rusty and brown. It is mainly caused by the deficiency of boron. Browning is mainly through the deficiency of boron. So control this, we can go for soil application of borax. So boron, it is mainly through the boron. So we will spray the borax 10 to 15 kg per hectare. Or spray the 0.25 to 0.5% solution of borax to control the browning. Whiptail. So whiptail plants become chlorotic. Later leaves may be stalk-like. The plants become chlorotic. The chlorophyll content will be reduced in the plant in whiptail. So whiptail is due to the deficiency of molybdenum. So to control this, we can spray the 1.5 kg sodium or ammonium molybdate. 1.5 kg sodium or ammonium molybdate, or spray the 0.1% ammonium molybdate we can spray to control the whiptail, to control the deficiency of molybdenum. That is mainly caused by the whiptail. Whiptail means deficiency of molybdenum. Blindness. The head not formed due to the damage of terminal buds. In blindness, the head will not form, head will not develop due to the terminal buds. So it is mainly caused by the low temperature, mechanical injuries of terminal bud. If there is any mechanical injury on terminal bud, low temperature or any insect attack. If there is attack of any insect, that is also called the blightiness. So careful handling of the plants. So to control this, we will go for careful handling of the plants. We can go and avoid the exposure of the plants to the low temperature. Plants will not expose to the low temperature. So it will develop the symptoms like cutworm, blindness. Next is riciness. The wavelet or granular appearance on the surface of the head. The wavelet, to cause it is a higher or low, it is mainly caused by the if the temperature is very high or very low or poor seed stock. To control the selection of proper varieties and transplanting at right time. So whenever we grow, we have to select a proper variety and transplanting in a time. We can use a good seed stock. Whatever the seed stock we use, that is free from the disease, and good seed stock we use to control the riciness. Next is hollow stem. The water-soaked and discolored tissue. It will develop the water-soaked or discolored tissue in hollow stem. It is mainly due to the boron deficiency and high nitrogen. Hollow stem is due to the boron deficiency and high nitrogen. If we apply the more quantity of nitrogen, that also causes the hollow stem. So to spray this boron deficiency, so we will spray the borax, 0.25 to 5% borax we can spray, and reduce the fertilizer dose of and closer spacing. So we will reduce the fertilizer dose with nitrogen. We will not apply so much quantity of nitrogen, and we will go for the close spacing to control the hollow stem. Will not go for the close spacing. So this is all about the physiological disorder, disease, pest, and production technology of broccoli. Thank you all. Good morning to all. Myself, Manoj Kumar Bundela, Assistant Professor, Suresh Gyan Vihar University, Jaipur. So we are discussing about the seed production technology of vegetable crops. So today we will discuss the seed production in carrot. Seed production in carrot, the scientific name of carrot is Docus carota. So content of this PPT is introduction about the carrot, scientific classification of carrot, what the most of carrot is orange in color, why, soil and climate, land requirement, seed and sowing, time of sowing, manure and fertilizer, spacing, varieties, irrigation, weed control, pollination of carrot, isolation, distance, method of seed production, plant protection, harvesting, and seed yield. This is introduction. Carrot. As we know, this carrot is a rich source of carotene. So carotene is used as a precursor for the vitamin A. It is a precursor for the vitamin A, riboflavin, rich source of riboflavin. It is a root crop. It is an antioxidant. It has the antioxidant and taste of salad. It is mainly used as a salad. It is mainly used for the taste for the salad. So this is the full form of carrot. It has a medicinal use also diuretic. It has a medicinal use also diuretic. Remineralizing, anti-diarrheal, overall tonic and anti-anemic. It is an annual or biennial herb with an erect and much bracted stem, 30 to 120 cm tall, arising from a thick fleshy taproot, 5 to 30 cm long, bearing flowers borne in umbel. A type of inflorescence is umbel. 5 to 30 centimeter long. The main carrot growing states are Haryana, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Punjab, and Uttar Pradesh. So these are the major growing state of carrot. Haryana is the leading producer of carrot in India. followed by the Andhra Pradesh. So Haryana is highest in production of carrot. After that, Andhra Pradesh is the second highest. It is originated from Afghanistan in Western Asia. Carrot is grown almost all parts of India. It is grown in almost all parts of India, both in the plains and in hilly areas. It is used as a fresh, as a salad, and cooked as a vegetable. Means carrot is used as a salad also, and it is also used as a cooked also. It is fresh. It is used for the fresh juice, pickle, and also gajar ka halwa is prepared from the carrot. Kanji is the most popular appetizer drink. Kanji is the most popular appetizer drink. It is prepared from the black carrot. The chromosome number of carrot is 2 and is equal to 18. Scientific classification. So scientifically, it is a kingdom is plenty. Order is Apiales. Family is Apiaceae. It is belong to the family Apiaceae. Genus Docus, species Carota. So scientific name is Docus Carota. The scientific name of carrot is Docus Carota. Climate. Carrot is a cool season crop. European and temperate type carrot require the cooler climate than the tropical and Asiatic type of carrot. So European or temperate type carrot, they require the low temperature as compared to the Asiatic type of carrot. The temperature range from 7 to 23 is considered as the optimum for the seed germination, while for the better root growth, 10 to 15 degrees centigrade temperature is ideal. So 7 to 23 is considered optimum for the seed germination, and 10 to 15 degrees centigrade is ideal for the better root growth. 15.6 degrees centigrade to 21.1 degrees centigrade develop the best orange color roots. So 15 to 21 degrees centigrade is good for the development of orange color roots. Very high or very low temperature is not conducive for the proper development of roots. If the temperature is very high or the temperature is very less, it is not good. At higher temperature, the roots become shorter, thicker, and non-juicy. If the temperature is more, the roots are become short, thick, and non-juicy, while at lower temperature, 10 to 15 degrees, they become longer. If the temperature is low, if the temperature is high, then the roots are short. If the temperature is less, then the roots are long. 10 to 15 degrees centigrade temperature, development of poor color. If the temperature is 10 to 15, the poor color development is there. 15 to 20 degrees centigrade, develop the good color. 15 to 20 means it will develop the good color, and 20 to 25 develop the less bright color. 20 to 25 temperature means it will develop the less bright color. Soil. Carrot grown well-drained, deep, loose, sandy, loamy soil, rich in humus, having the pH is 6 to 7. It is grown well-drained, deep, loose, sandy, loamy soil. The pH is 6 to 7. The sandy soil and sandy loamy and silt loamy are the best soil. Sandy loamy, sandy soil, sandy loamy, and silt loamy soil are the best. The soils are free from clods, are preferred for the smooth state roots. Means whatever the soils are there, it is free from the clods, so that the roots development will be better. Heavy clay soils or compacted soils may produce the abnormal development of roots. If the soil, heavy soils are there or clay soils are there, it will develop the abnormal development of roots, and the roots become overbranched. Land requirement. Field under carrot crop previous year can be used for the seed production. Uproot volunteer plants. We will go for the uprooting of the volunteer plant. Soil should be plowed to a depth of 30 to 40 centimeters and worked to a very fine tilt. Prepare the raised bed of 1 meter width, 20 centimeter height. Means when we go, we will prepare the beds 1 meter width and 20 centimeter height. Incorporate 5 to 10 tons per hectare of cattle manure, means 5 to 10 tons per hectare cattle manure we use, or compost to beds, and after that we will go for leveling of the bed. Can be done as, for monocropping we can go the single crop, for mixed cropping we can go for mixed cropping with the carrot with the other cool season vegetable crop, like we can go for the cabbage, cauliflower and all. Intercropping also, we can go for intercropping with dhania, carrot, radish and all. Seed and sowing. Seeds and sowing. The direct sowing is well prepared field for beds having the sufficient moisture. Seed rate is 6.25 kg per hectare. The seed rate of carrot is 6.25 kg per hectare. Seed are sown in 1.5 cm deep on a flat beds or ridges 10 to 15 cm high. Distance between the ridge is 45 cm for aseptic type and 30 cm for temperate type. The seeds are sown in 1.5 cm deep in flat beds. The temperature range of 7 to 23 is considered optimum for the seed germination. The temperature of 7 to 23 is considered optimum for the seed germination, while the seeds are slow germinated, taking 10 to 20 days. Thinning is done to maintain the distance of 4 to 5 cm between the plants. So why we have to maintain the spacing 4 to 5 cm between the plant, and we will go for thinning. Sowing time. The sowing of Asiatic carrot in plains is done in August to September, and August to September and by November to December the roots will be ready. August to September we will go for sowing, and November to December the roots are ready. Sowing of temperate type in plains for the root production is done during the October, December. In lower hills the time of sowing is August to September, in mid hills July to September, in high hills the time of sowing is March to July. These are the different type of sowing. Annual and fertilizers. At a market crop, it required the 100 kg of nitrogen, 50 kg of phosphorus and 50 kg of potassium. For seed crop, it required 50 kg of nitrogen, 40 kg of phosphorus and 40 kg of potassium. Spacing. So 30 into 40 cm into 5 to 10 cm for market crop, and for seed crop 60 into 45 cm, 45 into 45 cm or 45 into 30 cm spacing we will use. Carrot varieties. So temperate or European type of varieties. Good colored roots are produced under the lower temperature. The temperature is less, the good colored roots will be produced. Seed can be produced in hilly on account of chilling requirement. So according to the chilling requirement, the seeds are produced in hilly areas. Early Nanthus, Chetini, Pusa Yamdagini, Pusa Nanjyoti. So these are the temperate type of varieties. Tropical or Asiatic type of varieties. For good colored roots under high temperature, seeds can be produced in plains. Examples N29, Pusa Kesar and Meghali. So these are the tropical or Asiatic type of varieties. Irrigation. The crop required frequent irrigation of 4 to 6 days interval during the summer and 10 to 12 days interval during the winter or cool season. Frequent irrigation is required 4 to 6 10 days interval. 10 to 12 days interval for winter, and for cool season it required the less irrigation. Irrigation after a long dry period result into the splitting or cracking of the roots. So if irrigation after the long spell of dry period, it will cause the cracking or splitting of the root. Weed control. 2 to 3 hand weeding and light hoeing can be done 2 to 4 weeks after planting. The earthing of the plant once or twice at a root formation stage. When the root formation is there, that time we will go for earthing up of the plant, so that it will be, the roots will be developed properly. If we not go for the dhing cup, the plant will be fall down, means the roots will be not develop properly. When roots are exposed to the sunlight, they will develop the green color at the crown or shoulder. Pollination of carrot. So carrot is a cross-pollinated crop. Pollination is occurs mainly through the bees, means honeybees or any bees will be used. The pollen viability is depends on the temperature. So if temperature is less, the pollen will be more viable. Isolation distance. For foundation seeds, it is 1000 meter distance, and for certified seeds, it is 800 meter distance. The isolation distance is different for foundation and certified seed. Foundation 1000 meters and certified seed 800 meters. Method of seed production. We can use the two methods. Seed to seed method we can use, or we can use the root to seed method. So these are the two methods we use. In seed to seed method, the problem of root rot is more. In seed to seed method, root rot is the major problem. Root to seed method. When root formation is completed after 4 to 4.5 months, these are uprooted. When the seed root formation is completed, then we will go for uprooting of the roots after 4 to 4.5 months. Big core in carrot is not desirable. If the core size is big, then it is not desirable. Normally, the template varieties have the small and colored core after accelerating two to type characteristics. Separate the plants according to the size of the roots. When roots have been uprooted, replant stickling immediately. After that, we will go for uprooting of the roots. Store the root in trench and transplanting in spring. After that, we will store them and then we go for transplanting into the spring time. Roots are cut when we replant in spring. When we go for replanting in spring, that time we will cut the roots. Stage of field inspection. So normally field inspection will be done 30 days after sowing, at lifting of roots and staking preparation. First is 30 days after sowing, after that when the lifting of the roots or staking, and third one is at the time of flowering. So these are the three stages of inspection we have to do. Seed setting. Seed setting is 100% in primary emble, 90 to 100% in secondary emble, and 82.7% in tertiary emble. And the seed setting will be start to 100% in primary emble, 90 to 100 in secondary emble, and 82.7% in tertiary emble. The flowers are hermaphrodite, protenderous. Male will mature first. Flowers are hermaphrodite and protenderous. Protenderous means the male plant will be mature first. Protenderous. Androecium will mature first. Primary umbel, secondary umbel, and tertiary umbel. You can see in this the primary umbel, secondary umbel, and tertiary umbel. Roguing. Roguing are done first at the vegetative growth stage. First roguing will be done at the time of vegetative growth stage. Second, for the root uprooting and replanting stage. When we go for root uprooting and then when we go for replanting stage, that time we will go for roguing. Third, at full bloom period, when the flowers are completely developed, that time we will go for roguing. Fourth, at maturity, for the late bolters. Normally, for at the time of maturity, when the bolting will be occurred, that time we will go for roguing. So these are the four stages. First is vegetative growth stage. Second, root uprooting stage. Third, full bloom period. And fourth is maturity. Plant protection. In carrot, we do not have a serious disease in India, but a few common diseases are there, like leaf spot. For leaf spot, we can go for diethylene Z78, 0.2 to 0.3%. Bacterial leaf spot, common during the storage and transport. Thrips, they will suck the sap from the flowers. Use the melatonin or rogar we can use to control the thrips. Carrot fly, much hoeing is not desirable as the smell of the leaves attack the carrot fly and it will lay the egg in the disturbed soil and cracked field. Seed borne disease. The carrot leaf blight, seed borne, black rot or seedling blight. It is caused by the A. radicium, leaf spot, Cercospora caroti, brown root, wrote, it is called for the Gibberella adventis, Fomo wrote Diphtherial blight and Garret motley dwarf. So these are seed-borne disease. Harvesting and seed yield. The correct inflorescence is compound umbel. There are the primary, secondary and tertiary umbels. The primary umbels are mature first, followed by secondary and tertiary. So the harvesting is done at the interval of 2 to 3 splits. It has the 3 umbels, primary, secondary and tertiary. So primary umbels will mature first, then secondary, then tertiary. So we will harvest in 2 to 3 days interval. Seeds are threshed with sticks. After that, we will thresh the seed with the help of sticks. Seed yield is 5 to 6 quintal per hectare for temperate varieties and 6 to 10 quintal per hectare for acetic type of varieties. So seed yield is 5 to 6 quintal for temperate and 6 to 10 quintal for acetic type of varieties. 1000 seed weight is 800 gram, 800 milligram. Why most of the carrot is orange in color? So color of the orange is, color of the carrot is decided by the different genes. Like orange color of the carrot is due to the beta carotene. Red color of carrot, lycopene. Red color lycopene, orange color beta carotene. Purple color of carrot, anthocyanin. Yellow color of carrot is xanthophyll. Yellow xanthophyll, purple anthocyanin, red lycopene, orange beta carotene. Seed standards. So when we go for seed packing, we have to give the some seed standards like pure seed percentage. The pure seed percentage is in foundation seed it is 95%, in certified seed is 94% pure seed. Inert matter, the maximum inert matter will be 5% in foundation seed, in certified seed it is 6% inert matter. Germination percentage, for foundation seed the germination percentage is 60, for certified seed the germination percentage is 55%. For germination percent 55 for certified seeds. Other crop seeds, maximum in foundation seeds 0.05% and in certified seeds 0.10%. So these are the seed standard that we have to mention when we go for packing of the seeds. Like the what is the purity percentage, pure seeds, how much percent pure seeds, maximum pure seed percentage are there. Maximum is 95% pure seeds are there. Inert matter will be less, means very less. Maximum it is 5% only inert matter are there. Inert matter will be, germination percentage is how much is possible, means if it is more germination percentage are there, then it is more good. Other crop seed are maximum 0.05% other crop seeds are there. No more other crop seeds will be there in the crop. So the color we are already discussed, production technology of carrot means how we can develop the carrot. So normally we will use the root to seed method only for the seed production in carrot. Seed to seed method we will not use. So why we not use the seed to seed method? Because in seed to seed method, the root rot is the major problem. Seed to seed method means first we sow the seeds, after that the roots will develop and we keep the roots in field itself, and then after that in next season the flowering will be start. The roots inside the field means root is always in the field itself, means we will not remove the root, we will keep the root in field itself, and from that only the flowers will come. So what will happen, the root rotting, because roots are more time in the soil only, so there is a chance of root rotting. That's why we will not go for seed to seed method. Seed to seed method means root rotting is the major problem. That's why we will go for root to seed method. So first we sow the seeds, then we take the harvest the roots, then we keep the roots in trenches. We will store the root in trenches, and then after that, that roots again in next season we will use that roots for the seed production. So in this, the quality of the seeds are good. We will gain the more seed yield, and the chance of attack of any disease is very less in this. This is all about the seed production in carrot. Thank you. Thank you.